Hey everybody, this is Dream, and we have a massive 14-game Major League Baseball slate for you today that starts at 7 o'clock Eastern. This slate is pretty interesting as there's a lot of good games in it. We do have some weather concerns in Houston, Colorado game, and the Arizona Atlanta game. I think there's going to be some rain across the other games, but there's no real threat, at least at this point. So do make sure to check on Twitter and stuff for weather updates. With that said, let's get into it though. Before I do, can you guys smash that like and subscribe button? I'm also just going to give you my stackable teams today. And at the end of the video, I'm also going to give you my cheap value guys. So that's going to be a little bit different than normal. So just stay tuned for that. So for stackable teams today, we have Atlanta, Cincinnati, Houston, LA Dodgers, San Francisco, and San Diego. All these teams have really good matchups and good upside. So let's go ahead and get into our pitchers though. We are going to start with Mr. Keller from Pittsburgh. Now, he is a bit pricey today. He's been over 20 fantasy points in four of the last six games. He doesn't have the highest ceiling, but I do like some of the Kansas or the Cleveland bats as well. Though he is capable of a good game here, and he's had some solid games throughout the season. Like I said, his ceiling isn't that high, but his floor is pretty good, and so I do think he's viable here today as a good option. Musgrove for San Diego is also in play. Though he's only had one game over two earned runs in the past nine games, he's had seven wins in that stretch as well. His ceiling is also good. The matchup just isn't that ideal as he is facing Toronto, but he does draw some good upside in this matchup because of how well he's pitching, and his K rate's been pretty solid in that stretch as well. He's only had really one bad game against Tampa Bay on that stretch. Then we're going to look at, let's see. Then we're going to look at Giolito. For the Chicago White Sox. Now, he is not in the best matchup here against the Mets, but he has been over 25 fantasy points in four of the last seven games. His floor is higher than some of the others here, and he does have a decent K rate at times as well. With the trade rumors, he may be trying to put on a show as well, so that gives him some upside here. He's also been pretty solid recently, and especially in his last 10 games, averaging almost 19 fantasy points a game, and he isn't giving up a ton of earned runs either, so I do like his upside in this one. Then we'll look at over for Minnesota. Now he is facing Seattle here. He has pitched pretty well recently. He's had 17 or more fantasy point games and a decent chunk of games this year. I do think a 17 fantasy point game is in play here. I wish he were a little bit cheaper, but he hasn't had over three earned runs in a while, and his K rate has been improving. That gives him some utility here. He's just a little bit overpriced. Then we'll look at Jermaine for the Yankees. Since he had his big game where he had a perfect game, he's had two up and down games since then. He has improved on limiting the earned runs, and his K rate seems to have risen some, so he is pitching pretty well. But he still has a very bad floor, and that said, he is viable in a plus matchup here, as Ohtani is really the only big concern from the Angels' bats. But he is high risk, high reward today. Then we'll look at Skubal for Detroit. Now, I actually like him quite a bit here, as he's only started two games this season. He's only pitched four innings in each of those, but he's had five strikeouts in both. At least, and he hasn't been giving up many hits. He's only given up two hits in those two games, and he has some good upside here as he's been at least 16 fantasy points in both games. And those were actually one of those games against Toronto was actually a tougher matchup, and this is not a tough matchup against Kansas City. So I expect him to hopefully go a couple extra innings now and increase his innings and have another good game here. Though he is a little risky since he hasn't played a lot, he definitely has some upside in this matchup. Jordan Montgomery is a good option today for St. Louis as well. He's also a little bit risky, but he has had seven games over 17 fantasy points. Sorry, in the past seven games, he's been over 17 fantasy points in six of them, and he's been over 24 in four. He's got good upside here in a plus matchup. I do like one or two Miami bats today, but he draws some really good metrics here, and while he's been inconsistent throughout the season, he's pitched well recently. Then we'll look at Mr. Wu from Seattle. Now, he is facing Minnesota, who is one of the easiest or the best strikeout teams in this, on the slate. If you remove his first game versus Texas, though, he has no games under 17 fantasy points. He's only got one win in that stretch, but no games over two earned runs in any start either, with the exception of that very first game. So he draws a really good floor, and he's got a decent matchup, even though Minnesota does tend have a tendency to be able to score some runs. They also strike out a lot, and he's got some nice upside in this one. And then we'll look at Bryce Elder for Atlanta, as he doesn't have the highest ceiling, but he has been pretty safe most games. He's also cheap enough to be viable, but he's not must play, and he's in a risky matchup against Arizona, who's probably one of the better teams on the slate. He's also had a couple off games recently, but he has faced a pretty tough schedule, so I'll add that for those last couple games. That said, he is high risk, high reward, but he does have some potential today. Let's go ahead and get our catchers here. For Atlanta, we'll start with Sean Murphy. Now, he has hit the ball with 5 home runs in the last 9 games. He's been really solid this season. He's also got good upside, and he's in a great matchup here. I like his potential. Diaz for Houston is in an interesting spot here, as he has home run upside in this matchup. He's had 3 home runs in the last 10 games. He draws good upside, and that makes him viable here, as his game is in Colorado. And he's just cheap enough that you can utilize him. Blake Sabal for San Francisco. If he plays, he needs to get a home run to pay off here. But he's hit the ball really good recently, and he has a boomer bust feel to him, but he has upside, and he's nice and cheap. Alvarez for the Mets is also in play, as he's really improved hitting the ball with 5 home runs in the last 10 games. However, he has also had 6 in the last 8 games, 6 hits in the last 8 games, or I should say he's had hits in 6 of the last 8 games. His floor is pretty low, but his price is really good, and you can't get that kind of upside at this price. So I do like him here at this position, and there's a lot of good options. Nobody really jumps off the chart as a must play at catcher, but he's definitely a good one here. Moving into the first base, Ohtani is a great option. Since the All-Star break, he hasn't had a game without a home run, and he's had a bunch of games lately with 7 in the last 13 with home runs. He is absolutely just smashing the ball, and with all the trade rumors, it seems like he's really upped his play. He is hitting 300 and has a 10 fantasy point per game upside. He's really hitting well, and I like him here a lot. Lamont Wade Jr. is also in play here for San Francisco. Now, he has hit the ball a little bit inconsistent throughout the season, but he does have some upside here, and he's seems like maybe the last couple of games he's starting to get hits again, so I do like his potential here. He's also nice and cheap and gives him some upside. Josh Naylor is a core play for me for Cleveland. He's been over 10 fantasy points in 10 of the last 14 games. He's hitting very well with all sorts of upside in this matchup. He's hitting a ridiculous 410 in that stretch in those 10 games. He also has 3 home runs, and his fantasy points per game is over 13. I really like his potential here. Matt Olson is also in play for Atlanta, and he's a little bit pricey, but he's also hitting home runs like Ohtani does. And if you were to go super cheap in pitching, you could throw Ohtani and Olson in your lineup, and you would have a lot of home run upside. He's got a lot of good utility here. He's also hitting the ball pretty well, though he doesn't need a home run to pay off. He has good potential in this one for that. Then we'll look at Mookie Betts at second base. He could also play the outfield just like Ohtani can. He's got a lot of home run upside, as he's hitting them very well recently. He's averaging over 14 fantasy points per game and hitting 390. He also has 5 home runs in the last 10 games. He is viable as a ceiling as high as anybody on the slate, and he's on a team that does have some good potential today. Gleyber Torres for the Yankees is a little bit overpriced here, but he's had a lot of good games in a row, hitting almost 400. He hasn't hit a lot of home runs in that stretch, but he does have a lot of home run upside today as he draws good metrics for that on this particular matchup. Andrés Giménez has been in the pocket of potential trade rumors. He's also hitting the ball pretty well recently, which is really helping him. And he's had some home runs, which we really didn't expect. He's had a few in the last few games. Or I think he's had 2 in the last few games, and he does have some good upside, though his batting average has been inconsistent. He is getting walked and has stolen base potential, which helps him in the fantasy point perspective. Then we'll look at Duvan for Houston. Now, he can play second base or shortstop. I do think he's more viable here at second base than any, but he is a little bit overpriced. But he does draw a great matchup here in Colorado, and he has home run potential as a result, though he is somewhat high risk, high reward, as he hasn't hit a whole lot of home runs this season. But Houston is a decent team, as they seem a little bit underpriced today. Jose Ramirez for Cleveland is also in play. Now, he is fairly expensive, and he's been slumpy. But he did hit a good game yesterday, which gives him some upside. He still has home run potential, though he does need to hit one really to pay off here, as he's not had a lot of games over 10 fantasy points lately. Alex Bregman was very close to being a core play for me today, as he's a little bit underpriced for what he normally does, and he has good potential, though he is popped up his price as a result of the slump he's been in. But he had a big game a game ago where he had a home run against the Angels. He's got a great matchup here, and it looks like he might be coming out of a slump, which gives him some nice utility here, and he draws really good upside in this matchup in Colorado. You could also consider Ella De La Cruz, Austin Riley, Gunnar Henderson, J.D. Davis, and Rafael Devers at this position. Moving to shortstop, excuse me, we'll start with Corey Seager for Texas. He's hit the ball really well, and he does need a home run to pay off here, but he has had 3 in the last 7 games. He has plenty of upside. He's also hitting the ball at 350 this season, and he's a really solid player. He's priced very high, but he definitely has some good utility here. Bobby Witt Jr. for Kansas City is a guy that I do like today. He's hit the ball really well at a 300 average over the last 10 games. He also has home run upside, and he's had a few the last few games. He's had 4 in the last 10. He has good potential here. He's also been hitting the ball really solidly, and he has some stolen base upside as well. So he definitely draws good potential. He's a little bit underpriced. Gunnar Henderson is also in play. He's a little bit overpriced, but he's hitting the ball decently well. He has home run potential, though he is somewhat high risk, high reward. I do like Bobby Witt quite a bit better, but he is viable. And then Javier Baez, he's been a little bit slumpy for the Detroit Tigers, but if you do want to use anybody on Detroit, he's definitely somebody to use. He's been up and down throughout the season, but he has good home run potential in this matchup as he draws great metrics. But he's high risk, high reward, and he's a little bit risky due to his price. Then we'll look at the outfield here, and we're going to start with Ronald Acuna Jr., who is a core play. He is absolutely just tearing the ball off the tearing the cover off the ball lately. He's hitting home runs, he's hitting stolen bases, he's getting on base, making things happen. He's had some massive fantasy point games, and he's just primed for another good one right here. I really do like his upside. Some other options at this position for top plays are Kyle Tucker, who's hitting the ball really well at a 400 average. He was nearly a must play as well today. I really like Houston's upside. Otani, obviously. Mookie Betts, who I already mentioned at second base, can also play in outfield. Jake Fraley has some really good upside here, as he's hitting the ball decently well, though he doesn't have as much upside. He has good home run potential today. And then Juan Soto, who has some absolutely massive upside in this game against Manoa, but he hasn't hit the ball well recently. Maybe in our value plays here, we'll start with Jock Peterson for San Francisco. Now, he hasn't hit the ball well this season. He's been very slumpy, but he does have some good upside, as he is in a good matchup, and he has good potential. He just needs to have some good games to get out of the slump. He's a little bit pricey, so he's not a must-play, but he does have some utility here. Conforto for San Francisco has hit the ball pretty well lately with a 300 average almost over the last 10 games, and he has some home run potential in this matchup. He's also hit the ball pretty well the last few games, so I do like his upside. McCutcheon for Pittsburgh is in play, as he draws some good utility. He has home run potential, and he has been streaky, but he has hit the ball decently well throughout the season, so he has some upside in this matchup. Not a must play, but has some potential. Stanton for the Yankees, he needs home runs to pay off here, as his batting average is abysmal, and he really only pays off when he does hit home runs, but he does have the upside to do that today, and the home run metric is very high for him on this particular matchup. Stephen Kwan for Cleveland is in play. Now, he's not a home run threat today, but he's hit the ball fairly well at a 300 batting average over the last 10. He is a little bit pricey for his potential, but he definitely has some upside as he draws a good magic matchup here. Soler for Miami is a interesting play today. He has really hit the ball well recently with raising his batting average up. He's also had some really solid games, including some home runs. I don't know that he'll hit a home run today, but he does draw some good utility and has some good matchup metrics for this game against St. Louis. Anthony Santander is also in play for Baltimore, as he draws some really good metrics here against the Dodgers pitcher. He hasn't been consistent throughout the season, but he has home run upside, and he has had 3 of the last 10, and his batting average has been really solid recently. He does tend to be a streaky player, but while he's hitting well, he's definitely in play. You can also consider Blake Sabol, Chris McCormick, or sorry, Chase McCormick, Marcell Ozuna, Michael Harris, and Masataka Yoshida at this position. Then I'm going to just go through some quick sub-3,000 price players. Real quick, we're going to look at Brandon Crawford for San Francisco. He's in play here. Mike Yastrzemski is also in play for the San Francisco. For the Yankees, Perez draws some interesting upside if he does draw the start today. Then we'll look at Gallizer for the Baltimore Orioles. He draws some nice metrics. He hasn't hit a home run yet, but he is in play. Encarnacion Strand for Cincinnati is in play as he is up. He didn't have a good game yesterday, but I expect him to have some upside today. Brandon Belt also in play for Toronto as he has some nice upside. Benson is high risk, high reward, but he does draw some utility as he's nice and cheap. Neto for LA Angels has hit the ball really well recently, and he's one of the surprised players recently having a really good average over the last 10 games. Davis for Pittsburgh, Henry Davis here, he's hit the ball really well recently, and he draws some low-end upside here. And then Connor Joe for Pittsburgh also draws some utility as a first-base outfield option. So with that said, guys, thank you for liking, commenting, subscribing. If you have any comments or questions, feel free to leave them below, and have a nice day, guys.